Record's pretty much the same.
Yeah, 23-0 and 21-1. Here we go. Cusolito and Flores.
Flores is a tall guy, this weight class. 16 knockouts, but look at his frame. You think this guy can't punch, but he can punch pretty well. Skinny arms, skinny legs.
Yeah, and not much listed as a difference in the statistical numbers about their height and reach, but the way he fights tall.
Yeah, and you take a look at both guys have skinny legs, long bodies. He's got long arms. Looks like he has a long reach.
All right, so we feel like we're seeing two tall guys, but similar tall guys and not much separating them. Stylistically, what kind of fight do you think we're going to see?
Well, when I won the championship, I fought a guy who was 5'9", 118, and I broke him down to the body, broke his body apart. Eddie Fudge told me to break his left hooks, the body right hooks, long jab, move around, just stay close. But these guys are both tall, so they're going to want to try to pick each other off. And they sort of stand up straight, long punches.
I will note that you had a championship at 118, and Eddie Futch, the venerable Eddie Futch, said you were one of his five top guys of all the 20-some title holders that he had.
Eddie was unbelievable guy, brilliant trainer, best of all time, I think. But as a person, he was unbelievable.
Absolutely one of the all-time class acts, and you had a chance to interact with him and be trained by him.
I heard all the stories from 1930s and 40s.
Yeah, you really, when some guys tell them, you really soak it up.
Well, I used to sit at the dinner table with him all the time. This fight here is getting off. Flores getting that jab working well. Full overhand right.
Off to a good start here. Flores with a jab and a right hand. Wild miss by Cusolito. Flores looking for an angle. Double jab, and tries to load up, and then he fires a right hand to the body.
Flores is, he's a smarter one. He's, just like you said, he's giving the angles, and Cusolito's trying to pick him off as he comes in, but he stands up straight.
Flores has been able to dictate where this fight has taken place as he's been able to back up Cusolito, and there was a crunching right hand by Flores.
He dug deep with that one and right hooked the body. Cusolito coming back, but it's really, on paper, it was an even matchup, and in the ring it's an even matchup as well. And it's very rare you see this.
Sneaky right uppercut by Flores just missed, and we'll watch. We figure he'll go back to that as round number one will head into the books.
Flores coming in, he reaches a bit with his right hand, just swings it, good body shot. Then he jumps to the left hook, he leaves himself exposed for the right hand, he's got to be careful later rounds. Cusolito, he took the shot and came back.
Talk it over in the corner. Cusolito, as you hear, and then there's a corner of Chucky Flores.
Vamos, 10 segundos, ahí están en el centro del ring.
Round two of this scheduled 12-round WBA 122-pound championship underway on Premier Boxing Champions, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Dave Bontempo and Wayne McCullough with you. Glad you're enjoying this. And for Wayne, even a more special treat. You're champion at 118, fought a lot of 122, and here you see these guys in a weight class that quite familiar with in your day, and these guys have to make adjustments now because they're both tall.
Yeah, well, Flores, he uses a jab well. He moves in on angles. He's leaning a bit to his right, which is he's open for a big right hand over the top. You got to be careful with that. They say they're tall, but when I fought Eric Morales, he was 122, like 5'9". He was a tall guy as well, knocking everybody out. These guys are banging with each other, and somebody's going to go.
And these are fights you really like to see. Guys who have earned their way. Good right hand by Flores. And this is a rich division in boxing. We've seen a lot of them on Premier Boxing Champions, too. Leo Santa Cruz, Julio Ceja, terrific knockout victory last month in Los Angeles. As here comes Flores. Scott Quigg in this
good
division.
Good hand from Cusolito. He not overhand right. Flores took it. Both guys are standing trading more this round.
Good shots here by Flores. Finishing the thought that Carl Frampton is in this division too. Yes. We've seen a lot of these guys.
Regondo and Scott Quigg as well. It's a big division loaded.
Yeah, and what's really made the division, you know, fights like this. You know, guys have to earn their way, and then before maybe you wouldn't see these guys. Now here they are. Have to go over each other to make a name for yourself, and they're putting up a good effort. There's a good right hand by
beautiful
Flores and an uppercut.
Boxing needs this. Boxing needs fights like this to bring it back to the forefront, because, as you say, nobody does this anymore. They don't fight two young guys on their way up fighting each other. These guys are fighting for an interim belt, but they're trading blows hard. Nobody's giving any ground at all.
Benji Estevez warning both guys to keep it composed. Yeah, we're seeing a lot of fights on this series. Guys in the top 10 fighting each other instead of waiting to see if they can get to the number one ranking. Is he at number 5 and then the number 8? Let's see it.
They try to take the shortcut, but now the guys are fighting each other. And that's what this series does. It puts the best against the best.
That's what the glory era of boxing was. And this has been a terrific year for boxing. And on this fight, good start for Flores and Cusolito.
That was a good run, really good. Both guys down the good shots. Flores looked like he was looking for the knockout.
And Cusolito landing a good looping shot, and then Flores coming back.
You see Flores, he's uppercut, then right hand over the top. Switched to southpaw and then missed. I threw that one way back. Cusolito stayed in there. He did land a good right hand. I think it's coming up here. There it is, the right hand, beautiful, upper hand. That's where Flores is open for that shot. He leans a bit to his right, and he's wide open for that shot, so Cusolito threw the right punch.
Round three underway. 122-pound championship bout between Moises Flores and Luis Cusolito. Flores 23-0, Cusolito 21-1. 7 wins in a row. Evenly matched, and evenly coming out of the gate.
They both come out this round like the Met business. Cusolito come out on some good shots. But Flores back in control again, pushing him back. His overhand right. He loads up with that shot. Flores, a little dip like that, left hook, and he dips on through the right hook.
Flores loading up on that hook. And as we've seen earlier, and even tonight, he'll be vulnerable for a right hand if he doesn't get it there fast. So that's the risk-reward scenario when you load up for a shot.
Yeah, when Flores throws his jab, he watches his left hand drops just like that, and wide open. But Cusolito's just got to time it at the perfect time. Quick overhand right.
In the meantime, it's Flores getting off more. And he's getting in 3 to Cusolito's 1. He's good, a bit, uppercut.
He's busy, he throws a lot of combinations. He's like, this pace is pretty fast for this weight. Even they're throwing a lot of punches. Flores is, he just looks like he just wanted to get the knockout.
Well, we're going to mark that observation because we both believe that this is a fast pace for the 122-pound division. So if we're into round 8 or 9, we'll see if that shows up. That's always part of the intrigue.
You have to be really fast or crazy like me, because he threw 100 punches around. and did it in the 12th round. But both guys, they've thrown a lot of punches.
Yeah, these guys look like they could be 130-pound guys as far as their body frame, and down to 122. And then here's Cusolito dipping in, and then a good right hand by Cusolito.
I think the reason why they can do this weight class is because their legs are skinny. Most guys have good solid legs, but it hasn't affected these guys in their career at all. One loss between them.
Good right hand by Cusolito. Yeah, but then you see guys that they go up a little bit too much and they don't have that sturdiness behind them. Tommy Hearns was moving up, as phenomenal a puncher as he was. You know, he looked at those legs like this and
they fall over.
How much is too much?
Yes, everyone knows.
This is a great action fight from toe to toe.
Yeah, nice pace for Flores and Cusolito.
Oh, good right hand again from Cusolito. He landed good right. Flores is definitely open for that right hand. Good action fight.
This is what Flores is doing his best work.
He does a nice uppercut first inside. Cusolito can push him back. Cusolito landed a good right at the end of the round. Coming up here. There it is, right hand. He's open for that. Flores is open for that shot. Cusolito's just got to time it right time.
Round four underway. Moises Flores and Luis Cusolito, going for a 122-pound championship. And it's been an excellent start to this one. Good hook by Cusolito, and comes up with another one.
Back and forth, the good body shots back to the head.
Good jab here by Cusolito. Flores with the left hand down, and we're seeing his left hand down by his side for the first time.
And he's throwing it like he put good intention, but he left himself wide open for that right.
Good right hand by Cusolito over that low left hand by Flores.
And Flores, he's wide open for that shot, and Cusolito's just got to right on the button with it. But Flores is not used to losing. He's never lost, so he doesn't feel like to lose.
Now, what do you read into it as a fighter when you see a guy who all of a sudden in the fourth round of a fight now lowers the hand, left hand, and starts to fight it? Do you get a sense that maybe he's tired, or is he trying to load up?
He's getting tired, but he just threw about four or five punches there, landed clean on Cusolito.
Back and forth, some momentum for Cusolito.
There's a right hand, that wobbled him.
Right hand.
That wobbled him, Dave, that time. He wobbled.
Here he comes, Cusolito opening up. Good left hook to the body by Cusolito.
He senses something. Flores is hurt, but look at that.
Watch this guy come back after he was drilled.
He came back pretty strong, too.
And Cusolito is thinking, what is this? I just hurt you.
I hurt you and you came straight back at me.
Flores working the body. Good uppercut by Flores. And since he came back, he's driven Cusolito back. Good uppercut by Flores and a left hook by Cusolito.
This is great fight, great quality shots.
These guys are in a casino and they are gambling.
They're gambling right there. It's a good fight.
Yeah, you're waiting for someone to make the adjustment and maybe play it safe, but this has not evolved that way, which is why it has been so pleasing.
No, neither guy won't give any room. One gets hit a good shot, the other one backs off, and he can strip back with a punch of his own.
Good left hook to the body by Flores.
He's not just throwing the body shots, he's digging deep, he's digging in as hard as he can with them shots. And Flores taking him straight back again, body shots of his own.
The quality of the punches, very strong for these guys as we come to the end of round four.
Great fight, great fight. The fans are getting the money's worth here for tonight.
And take a look at some of the money's worth they're getting.
Uppercut, he threw the uppercut to the right. Good. Flores, good shots. Cusolito tries, but lands a few, just covers up. Here's again Flores coming forward. Right hand from Cusolito. If he just timed that perfect shot, the full left hook behind it, I think Flores would have success. And Cusolito would definitely have success with the right hand left hook. Action packed from the start.
This has been some pace. One of boxing's treasured areas, the little guys down 126 on down. Always give you the great action fights. These guys look bigger, but they're really performing with a high pace. Moises Flores and Luis Cusolito fighting for an interim 122-pound championship, which Flores won in his last fight. 12-round split decision back in April.
Flores has piled the pressure on at the start of this round. Good body shot, digging really hard. Right hook, left hook.
Here comes Flores putting the pressure on.
Cusolito always looks like he's fading a little bit, then he can straight back with punches of his own.
Good right hands here by Flores, and a wild shot by Cusolito. Cusolito now in a countering mode.
Yeah, he has slowed down a little bit, where Flores is just, he's non-stop. That guy is just non-stop punching.
The Energizer.
Chucky, his nose is busted. Flores. His nose is bleeding. He broke.
Jab here by Flores. Good right hand by Flores. And now putting the pressure on Cusolito.
Nice punches. He's just digging deep with every shot, body shot. One left hook to the head was a great shot.
They were trading before, but now it's mostly Flores.
They just get hit with the right hand there, you get hurt. Flores get rocked. With another right hand.
Cusolito, nonetheless, makes his
count. Here we go. Great fight. Another right hand. Cusolito just loading up with it. The three right hands in a row. After Flores was controlling this whole round.
That's the beauty of seeing guys who are at the top of a division and belong there. They're going to have their second win. They're going to have their bounce back situations because they're good enough to find another gear.
And sometimes when they find out of the gear, they step up to a different level. Start hitting harder.
Good body shot by Flores.
He throws that from way back, but still lands it.
I think that one came over the border from Guadalajara.
Wow.
It had a passport.
Cusolito comes straight back with uppercuts of his own.
Good right to the body again by Flores. And then he backs up and gives himself room. Cusolito trying for the one shot.
Him body shots out of it. They gotta hurt. They gotta hurt.
This is investing.
Yeah, he looks like he's hurting. Definitely for sure.
Good round. Again.
Good action. Just a little the right hand again. If he threw a left hook behind it, I think he'll have success. But this round was one way, went the other way. Flores uppercuts, throwing everything behind it, getting the whole body behind it, body shot. Here we go again. The right hand again from Cusolito. Rocked. Flores, first time to fight, been really rocked. But he came back again.
Está bien. Sentí
And we get ready for round six. Moises Flores and Luis Cusolito hooked up in a shootout.
Round six already. Flores looks like he's just starting the first round all over. Just nonstop.
He has come out strong every round, and this is a real testament to your conditioning, because you can't do this without the road work. Can't do this without getting up in the morning when you don't want to get up. Putting in the work, paying the price.
And you gotta get up and smell that. The morning, dew in the morning, the cold. 5 o'clock in the morning, 5:30. Look at this. Who is just pounding the pressure. Costello comes straight back with the right hand.
Cusolito leaning down on Flores, warned by the referee.
Flores almost ran at him there, just to get back quickly. Right hand landed from Flores, good shot.
Here he comes, right hand, left hooks. Even turns southpaw for a second, then goes back. Uppercuts. Here comes Flores lined up. Good body shot continues. And then the beautiful left hook after he stepped back.
I think Flores has landed at least 3-1 punches.
Yep, he's continuing that ratio. And these are not just any three. No, these are all high quality.
They're high quality, picking the shots. He's not wasting any punches.
I mean, it's one thing to look at numbers and say, okay, he's throwing a lot of punches. But the deeper level is when you can look at the percentage of high quality shots. And these are not just numbers, these are real meaningful punches.
And quality is the word you use. It's just jab, right hand, trying to get the uppercut. Cusolito looks like he's fading a little bit, but using him straight back with a right of his own.
I think that's the next statistic they should put into boxing, but it would be so subjective, but it really is a separator. When you can look at how good these punches are, not just if they're landing.
But we talk about how fast this was at the start, it's still just as fast. Flores is definitely the quicker of the two.
And Cusolito starting to hold on a little bit.
You're right.
Looking for one shot. They're hooked by Flores, and Cusolito gave up on the exchange a little quickly and paid for it.
Quality shot, body shots, head shots. Flores just piling the pressure on. And Cusolito looked like he was hurt a little bit there. But he can strip back again with a 1-2. Action pack, action.
Halfway throw, a barn burner.
Long left hook from Flores. Cusolito just backs off, puts his hands high, blocked half that punch. You see it again. He throws the right hand first, then drops the body with the left hook. Uppercuts, hooks to the head. Cusolito looked like he was fading a little bit, but he came straight back at the end. Rose's eyes swollen up a little bit. I don't think he's cut. Just swollen up.
How we start the second half of the fight. It has been a real good one between Moises Flores, the 122-pound champion, the WBA, this class, and Luis Cusolito. Dave Bontempo and Wayne McCullough with you. It would seem like Flores would have control of the scorecards based on his aggression, but how about you? How are you
Flores
seeing
Flores up 5-1, actually. A lot of the runs have been close, but he's just a busier guy, none of them were the better shots. And Cusolito is always there, but he's just sporadic punches. He lands a right hand and backs off. Flores is just busy, 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 busy. When he gets hurt, he's busy again.
He has been outgunned, has Cusolito. And we were wondering when the fight started, who's going to force a change in style, and whether they would do it by using an angle or whether they would do it by using power. And Flores has done it by using overwhelming power.
You're right, he has. He just, he pushed forward at the start, but now he's pushing forward even harder. And Cusolito was finding it hard to keep him back from backing him off. He found it really, really difficult. But Flores has got to slow down sometime. He has to.
And from his perspective, what he hopes is that he's got such a big lead at that point that he'll have the money in the bank.
Maybe Cusolito will get a second win, come back strong.
Good right hand by Flores. Now, what about the pacing element in the fight? Okay, this is a fast-paced fight. You were a fast-paced fighter. Did you have the sense of pacing throughout the fight, or is there so much adrenaline that you say, here's chances and I have to take them?
Well, the way I fought, I knew. I started slow. I always started off slow. The first couple rounds, I was slow, so the guy tried to stay with me. But as round 5, 6, 7 went on, I got stronger, and they faded away, and a lot of my stuff just came in the later rounds. And Flores is that type of guy, he's non-stop, and he's keeping the same pace he did the first, second round. Plus, they just get landed the right hand better.
And the interesting thing to me, looking at it, okay, you're a fast-paced fighter, so you're already operating at high octane, and now, how do you avoid a situation like maybe the crowd can let you even push in a little bit more and then maybe not have as much left because you're in the moment as well. There's emotion as well as what you've trained for.
You got to know you can do 12 rounds and get stronger in 11th and 12th round. You know, because I'm an old school. I would love, when I left, took it in by Floyd, beautiful shot. I would love to have been a 15-round fighter, but they just took that away when I started my pro career. You see both guys landing shots. With that right hand from Cusolito. Just trading shots, big shots. And these are not easy shots. People watch home, these are hard punches these guys are landing. And they're hurting each other, but both guys are taking the shots and coming back. But you gotta know in your mind you can do 12 rounds fast. And make it slow.
As good as new.
Because when you get to that 7th and 8th round, you start slowing down, you're in trouble. That's why 15 rounds would have suited me a lot better.
That's right, they took it away just before. For safety reasons, of course, in boxing. And we move ahead into round 8. Moises Flores. Luis Cusolito, 122-pound championship on the line. It belongs, the interim belt does, to Flores, and he's done a very good job protecting it.
He's doing pretty well here as well. He's slowed a fraction, and Cusolito's sort of throwing a lot more punches.
Flores out, and there we see one. We're starting to wonder if these guys outlawed the jab.
I think Flores' best punches is the body shots when he lands him. Cusolito seems to be affected by them, but he lands more punches to the head instead of working the body.
Now, you see something when you're fighting. How often did you see something and your trainer saw something else, and in between rounds, you'd have a different view of it?
Sometimes you don't see things, and your trainer would say, you do this or do that, or he's open for that, or you hurt him with this, and you're like, you say, go ahead and try it. And you go ahead and try it, it works, you're like, okay, he was right.
What's interesting is when a guy like Flores, he's a pressure fighter, but what if his corner says, hey, come on, jab a little bit now.
Have you used a double jab, triple, even a triple jab, a jab to the body and then right hand behind him? He'd be an even better fighter, but he hasn't tasted defeat in his career, so he's not going to change anything.
Cusolito now firing wild shots.
Good body, left hook to body, dug that deep. I think Cusolito had a better run. First in a while.
Stop. No vuelvas. Espérate. ¿Entiendes? Let's go.
There's a hook by Cusolito, and if that had been four rounds ago, that might have really rocked Flores.
Cusolito getting off a little bit better. Flores is still busy, but his punches are not as effective.
Good right hand by Flores.
Left hook first, then the right hand behind it.
Looping right by Cusolito.
I think Flores, the sting on the edge of his punches is it's not the same as it's been the last few rounds.
Well, that was a blistering pace they set.
This guy's trading right hand. Oh. Good run. Non-stop action. Left hook, right hand from Flores. Cusolito come back with a left hook of his own. Just trade blows. One guy lands, the other guy lands, bottom back. Left hook, right hand again from Flores. Left hook back from Cusolito. Great action fight. Neither guy giving any ground at all.
It's made it a real fans fight.
The Flores is his face is marked up more than Cusolito. It's weird. He's landing more punches than Cusolito, but his face is getting a little bit busted up.
Into round nine. Moises Flores, Luis Cusolito.
Just a little digging hard to the bottom line. Uppercuts, right hook, left hook. Left hook to the head.
Cusolito finding some new life. And then a right hand coming back by Flores. Sometimes you move on the angle, sometimes you try to set up shop, and sometimes you just let it go. And that's what these guys are doing in this fight.
Both guys are just letting them go, and Flores just marching forward still, trying to land a big shot, just landing a good right hand there. But Cusolito's got a good knack of getting his hands a little bit quicker, blocking some of the shots.
Looping uppercut, and then a left cross from that southpaw style from Flores, and now he's back.
He's winging the shots like he's still got that one punch power on the end of it, but the snap's gone a little bit.
Well, now this points to something you brought up earlier about Flores, like being a more complete fighter. The next level in his development, you would think, so, okay, you got up this big lead now. Now we're gonna let you fight with the lead.
Yeah.
We don't have to take as many risks, and you box a little bit more, and you make your opponent even more desperate to get you.
He's not that type of fighter. I think his corner should have told him to get back, get on the jab. The jab, he didn't really have a good jab, but he worked the jab. You're well in front, just win the rounds. But you know what? He looks like he's just trying to get his opponent out of there and get a knockout, where he should settle down and try to win the rounds.
So, but there's a fine line between what you're telling a guy. You want him to put a little more technique into it, but you don't want him to lose his aggressiveness, and you've got to find that spot.
You've got to find that spot, but sometimes us fighters are just too stubborn. We're so stubborn, we're like, just want to go in there and...
There is no spot.
Sometimes not listen.
Good right hand.
Beautiful.
By Flores. Cusolito backing up and tired.
He looked like he hurt him in that hook.
Good uppercut by Flores.
But I'd like to see the punch deck. These guys are throwing a lot of punches. Flores is throwing a lot of punches. I'd like to see how many he's throwing per round.
He's thrown quite a bit, and in the other element, high level quality shots too.
Yep, quality shots. And he's still going. He's got a good engine. He's fit. Look at that left hook right hand, left hook right hand. Wow. Give me one, I had you two.
And that's the storyline, that fans love it, trainers hate it.
Yeah. Sometimes you gotta listen to your trainer. You tell them the truth.
Yeah, we'll go into that more as we start round 10. Yeah, sometimes, you're right, you do have to listen to the trainers, and sometimes I've heard some trainers not give their guys meaningful advice between rounds. So no, it's really the chemistry. Right.
You gotta get the chemistry, you gotta be close to your trainer. And with me and Eddie Fudge, we had that connection where I listened to everything he said, and he was always right.
And then when he would talk to you, there was a lot of respect between rounds, not talking down to someone.
Eddie never yelled at me once. He just calm as cucumber and told me exactly what to do. And I went and tried to do it.
Now, what would you be telling each of these fighters now, between 9 and 10 coming out here?
I would tell Cusolito he needs to work a jab, push Flores back, because he's behind in the fight. And I would tell Flores to get the jab working, which is not going to happen. Get a double jab, give yourself room, and try to catch Cusolito when he walks in. He's going to come in looking for the knockout. But as you see, that's not going to happen.
So I'm waiting for the trainer to say, I would suggest you throw a jab. I just thought I'd throw it out there.
No, if Flores' corner is smart, they know he's well ahead. And Cusolito is going to look for the win, so he's going to march forward. He's going to walk onto something. But that's not happening.
Jab in the right hand here by Cusolito, trying to sit down on his punches a little more.
Having a little bit more success with it in this round. Unless I'm wrong, I think he's well behind. But he's winning this round.
Jab in the right hand by Cusolito, and getting to Flores here and marking him.
He actually threw three or four punches, and Flores didn't throw anything back, which is weird.
Good left hook by Cusolito.
Good run.
Good right hand by Flores.
It's tough. Just when you think he's going to fade away, he comes back. Big right hand, Kim. Swinging. Look where his hands are. They're just, he's just winging the shots.
You throw yours, I throw mine.
I think Costa is sick of hitting him. He hits him with everything. He doesn't do anything. Just marches straight back. There he goes again. Jab, jab. Right hand.
So Flores backing Cusolito up.
What's he trying to do? Is he trying to time a shot as he comes in? Close run.
One of the better ones for Cusolito in a while.
It was. We're still going this speed after 10 rounds. Look at that wing. Flores wings that shot from the back of the room, and he still landed with it. Uppercuts. But Cusolito's face, he doesn't get marked up at all. Flores is the one who's marked up. He's the one landing more punches. Some guys are like that, they just swell up a lot easier or get cut. He looks like he's in a tough fight.
That's what a fighter looks like. That's what a warrior looks like.
Sometimes too brave for own good.
As you look at their respective corners now, if you're in the corner of Cusolito as he gets drilled,
they both just walked straight out and swung at each other. Traded toe to toe. Look at this.
You know, rarely do you see a fight with two tall guys who don't jab. I can understand classic walk-in fighter, smaller guys, because that's been their way. But these guys have the style that somebody would have been telling them to jab because they're tall. And they outlawed it, and it's been some fight.
See, both guys are used to knocking people out, so they just walk in and try to get their opponents out of there. But they're in a fight tonight where they're both evenly matched, and neither guy's given any ground. One gets hurt, the other one gets hurt. It's back and forward.
I'm Stefan Chucky.
Flores is the one, for me, who's just controlled some of the closer rounds.
Taking nothing for granted.
Castellino's still trying. Oh, he got hit.
Good left hook by
he heard
Flores.
That. Yes, he heard that punch from here. Wow. That was a hard shot.
And Cusolito took it. These guys,
they both took their hardest shots. And
extremely well conditioned.
Both well conditioned. Both good, solid chins. And it looks like unless something happens, it's going to go 12 rounds. But because they fought so hard, you'd like to see it go the full distance.
And these guys have set the good pace, and Flores has been the guy getting off the mark first and being able to shift
Flores
Cusolito.
He's shifting him around, he's better movement, and he's got to be throwing at least 100 punches around. He's got to.
One no contest for Flores in 2012. Mario Munoz, a deep cut in the left eye of Munoz in round four, and the crowd rioted. They didn't want that fight being stopped.
Flores just pressure. Cusolito was just slowing a little bit here.
They're trying to implore.
The corner were jumping up. Cusolito's corner were going crazy there.
Good right hand by Flores, and Cusolito in some trouble.
Commission said something to the corner. They did something. I don't know what they were doing.
Well, there's a fine line between coaching and overdoing it, but you have a towel in your hand. They may think you want to stop the fight.
That's what I think it looked like. I think the commission thought he was going to throw the towel in because Flores just piled the pressure on. Cusolito took a lot of shots. Flores is just non-stop. Impressive. You see the action again. Flores pushing forward. Good right hand. Cusolito was hurt. He was definitely hurting that right hand. Covered up a little bit. Took a few uppercuts. Left hook. But then came straight back with him. But he was hurt with that shot. That right hand definitely hurt him. This last run, a fast run.
It's been an entertaining brawl.
Great fight. These guys deserve $1 million each tonight.
Well, you know what? They have really put a good effort up. Tap it up to start round 12, and here we go. Flores and Cusolito. Cusolito love coming from behind us. Native of Argentina, and Flores from Guadalajara, Mexico, fighting in Pennsylvania. It's a true international showcase for our worldwide audience.
And they both just started this round like they're starting the first round all over again. Fast pace, well-conditioned athletes.
Would you call this throwback?
Oh, this is my old school. I love the old school.
Yeah.
You know, keep fighting. Cusolito was rocked with that left hook. He's hurt
here
for the
he
first
comes
time.
Around. Cusolito hurt. Good left hook.
No,
ben
no,
Jentovic
no.
says no more.
No. He should have given him a condi. I thought that was a. Oh.
Well, interesting. That's the classic example of where you would use
just
a standing eight count.
Yeah.
And they don't have that tool. So.
They need it there. The guy, you know, he was hurt, but he wasn't
No, that's, and I think that's the referee looking at the exhaustion factor and what's come before it. And maybe seeing what the corner had done last round.
He almost fell back the ropes. So if the ropes is holding him up, then he should give a standing count. You see, Flores banging. He hit him a good shot left. That left took his legs wobbled. Cusley was hurt. Well, right hand. And he's ready to grab him. Look, right hand again. But he blocked that left hook. The referee jumped in. It's a world it's a world championship fight. You know, the guy wants to go out in a shield. And I don't think he got the chance to do that.
And that's well expressed. That is the old school philosophy.
Not taking away from Flores. Great fight. Cusolito showed tremendous guts. Came back one round. But Flores is winning the fight on my scorecard. But it's a world championship fight. Come on. If you go back to the old school fighters, they get knocked down and get back up.
Now, how about the fact that he was slowing down, though, and his reaction time seemed
down,
less?
But people use the, oh, what has going to happen to him in 10 years, this, that, and the other. You know, it's like, I had 353 fights amateur and pro, and I'm still talking to him.
353.
I'm like 353, and I lost 11 amateur fights out of 319.
So when you add up from the 353, that's 300-some wins.
I can still add it. I only lost a few of them, but I just like, you know, a guy goes out. I know there's damage in boxing, this, that, and the other, but you know what? This guy is that type of fighter. He fights like that. You know, he wanted to go out on the shield and finish the round. And it's not like he was on the canvas, on his back, really badly hurt. But great fight. Either way, great fight.
And you talk to a referee, he'll say better a minute too soon than a second too late. So
I know as a fighter,
sure.
If I was a commissioner, I'd be a lot different. I'd be different, believe me. I go back to the old school, have smaller gloves, 6-ounce gloves back in the old days. But knockout comes quicker.
You know what? You see the philosophy of what Benji Stevens was doing. And in a lot of fighters, now we saw a little bit more fire in the eyes of Cusolito tonight, but in a lot of fighters, when they're in that situation, they are gone. And this was an exception to that.
The referee, he sees better than us. Left hook and under there, look, left hook, he wobbled. Referee stays close, okay?
Good right hand landed. That's two big shots.
Three big shots. Left hook, he blocked the left hook and then he touched him, but he's gone the ropes. Could have been a standing count on the ropes. You can give him a standing count.
If you had the tool, you could use it there.
But they don't have it here.
They don't have it. So now the referee is forced to make a decision.
Is it the rules in here? Is it the rules in WBA?
But they said that they
that's
hear.
The rules here. So
that's what they were using.
But if it's a world championship fight, it should be the rules of the WBA. The guy was hurt. The referee was close. And he might see something we didn't, but I just... And you go back to the old school tour, got to make it war, even not old school, but modern day.
I'd be curious to see what the scorecards are at the end.
57 seconds of the 12th round. Our referee in charge, Benji Estevez, waves off the bout for your winner by technical knockout and still undefeated, Moises Chucky.